she had accumulated a couple of different things because one night she stole this guy's iPhone. It was trying to, proposition her.
Okay.
And she took his iPhone.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, they're not really cool with that nowadays in sports. There's a lot of things on the news with iPhones being taken. And then that's the robbery one. And then she assaulted my ex-girlfriend. And she got upset and called the cops on her.
Oh, gosh.
That's over there. And then the other two are misdemeanors, like misconduct and, you know, but...
So you're waiting.
Felonies, the other two, so I'm just worried, you know.
You're worried about her.
Yeah.
Well, that's thoughtful of you.
It's harder out here without her. Yeah. She's the money maker, you know. I do all right, but she does a lot better than me.
When you see people sleeping on the streets, you wonder, how did they get there? Every person has a story. Each of us has a story. We need to know more about them. How did they get from home? How did they get to the streets? You see them lined up at churches, even in Manhattan, waiting to get food, with their bundles, they get fed, and then, you know, at night they're going to find a place outside an office building, in a park, try to keep warm, spend the night. But what's needed ultimately is some kind of answer, a solution, or different options, different solutions. Government agencies, local, state, federal, is a major problem in the city of New York and across the entire United States. And it's really inexcusable, especially in the 21st century, that tens of thousands of people, Americans, have to sleep on the streets or in shelters, but many on the streets. We see them every day. We get familiar with them in the city. We see the same people. Sometimes we wonder who they are. Did this woman who's near my office have a family? Is she the mother of somebody? How did she end up on the street? You almost want to ask. But they need help, and they need help from government agencies. They need help from us as citizens. But being the United States of America, one of the wealthiest, most productive countries in the history of the world, it really is inexcusable. People should not be forced to sleep on the streets at any time of the year.
Although it's a very sad sight when you see a homeless person on the streets, when it's cold especially, you can't help but think there are places that they could go to. There are shelters, there are churches, there's places that they could go for help. So you can't help but wonder, why do they not help themselves? I don't really recall ever giving any money to a homeless person, but I do have sympathy, and I feel very bad, and you don't like to see these people on the streets, but there are places to go.
It was a very, very cold night that night. I was assigned to West 44th Street and Broadway, and I was on the footpost there, and I myself that night had about two pairs of socks on, winter socks, and also my combat boots, and my feet were still freezing. So basically, I was standing there, and I'd heard somebody laughing, joking around, and I looked over, and somebody was laughing, this elderly gentleman who had no socks, no shoes on, no anything, and I went up to him, and I was like, where are your shoes? He's like, it's okay, officer. He's like, I've never had a pair of shoes. He's like, but God bless you, you know, thank you for doing what you're doing. And that really, it had taken me back because, you know, this gentleman had enough heart to say, God bless me, but he didn't even have a pair of socks on, and I can only imagine how cold that pavement was. And so I ran a little bit ahead of him because he was headed south on 7th Avenue, and I knew the area, there was a shoe store. So I ran into the shoe store, and I had explained to them there was an elderly gentleman with no socks on, no shoes on. And I said, listen, I'd like to buy a pair of boots, something that's going to last a while. I don't care what the price is. We got to do this as an elderly gentleman out there with no socks. And Skechers helped me out, so while they were waiting to find out what pair they have, I ran outside and I grabbed the elderly gentleman. And, you know, I said, listen, I got a surprise for you. So I brought him to the Skechers. I sat him down and asked him what shoe size he was. And he said it was a size 12, so I ran back in there. And I said, listen, you got a thing in size 12? And they came right out. And I paid, and I brought the shoes and the socks out. And I knelt down, and that's when Jennifer had taken the picture. But to my surprise, I didn't see anybody there at that time. I didn't even know somebody had taken a picture. And so I was just doing my job. I just knelt down, put the socks on them, the shoes on them, lifted them back up. And I said, listen, sir, I was like, you want to grab a cup of coffee? Maybe we'll get something to eat. And he goes, no, officer. He goes, he said, no, officer. He's like, listen, you've done enough. He said, God bless you and be safe. He's like, I love the police. And that, again, it's just, you know, when I brought out the shoes, it was just smile ear to ear. So it was absolutely amazing. And I was able to share that moment with him, and he just continued to walk on his way. He didn't ask for anything, and it was a great moment for both of us.
We don't get paid for what we do. The money that we do raise, we go out and buy more food and stuff for these kids here. Every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, we do the same thing over and over again. But what happened was, I remember 25 years ago when I was in the shelter, I was homeless. I wasn't sleeping on the train, but I was homeless. And so what I had to do was go through a lot to get where I'm at today. So I knew what it felt like to be hungry.
Yeah. Like to be hungry.
You know, I knew what it felt like to, you know, where you ask somebody for a meal. It's like asking somebody, oh, can I get $1,000?
Yeah.
So what I did was I decided that this is what I want to do. And thanks to the man upstairs, this is how we started. They had another organization called UHO. They started out okay.
You get paid by being blessed for doing what you do.
There you go. And that's my payment. I don't look for any money, you know, because I know that. And some days I work 5 days a week. Some days I don't even want to come out. But I know if I don't come out, there's somebody like this young lady here or somebody else that might have been hungry and I could have fed them today. So
yeah,
it's a blessing for me, you know, to do this. Now, don't get me wrong, I do have people that, you know, curse you out or say this, don't go there, this, don't go there. I've been doing this for 5 years. And I had no problem. I had people that seize me. I don't have to say anything. They see me, they know. So they donate. Some people call me. Right now, what we're trying to do is we're trying to get the gifts, get some gifts for homeless and homeless families, and come together and what we do, we put on our law, Santa Claus films or whatever. And we go to different shelters giving out the gifts.
All right, thank you very much.
No problem. Thank you.
Have a happy holidays.
My name is George. God bless you.
Happy holidays.
You too. Thank you all. God bless you all, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Thank you. No problem.